Good evening. It's 7 p.m. It's Friday, the 5th of April, 2024. I'm Eller, and this is the TV teaser. We have another mixed bag of TV questions and puzzles for you, starting as usual with our classic clip round.
Okay, silence. Okay, stop.
He gave your
fingers
answer.
On the buzzers. Fingers on the buzzers. Fingers,
okay.
Stop. Which is the odd one out and why?
Dr. Martin will answer. That's the shoe question.
The odd one out because she doesn't design her own shoes.
No.
Is virtually Ian.
It's virtually Ian.
No. Go on. I just want to hear what Ian's got to say.
I'm a virtual character now. Well, I won't answer if that was right, because it'd be a waste of time.
But the answer is they all get money from shoes, apart from Theresa May, who's just famous for wearing the Conservative Party.
Well, she's not, though. She's had a range of shoes designed for her this week. That's what I was trying to say. Beckham has a range of shoes. Boots. P. Diddy has leisure wear, and Elaine Hamilton...
Christine.
..has just eaten a spider.
Well done, well
it's
done.
Her.
That is more or less exactly...
Christine Hamilton.
..more or less exactly the right answer. They've all designed their own range of clothing, except Theresa May, who was this week presented...
Oh, I was completely wrong, then.
..with a specially designed pair of shoes by Russell and Brock. No, I thought you were right.
No, I said that answer you've just read out.
But Beckham doesn't design his own
clothes. No! Boys, you edit a magazine?
And he said he was right. He said he was
right. What on earth are the editorial meetings like?
No.
Well, you ask me a good idea, I'll put it on paper. Oh, I think you should do that. Oh, really?
What time is it now? Shall I go home? Oh, I'm here. Look, I don't edit a magazine about shoes, but I'm trying to be fair to all of you. You've all done exceptionally well on this question.
And for the first question of the night, can you tell me who the two regular team captains are on Have I Got News For You? Round 2 is our daily anagram. I don't think this one should cause you much trouble. Unscramble the letters to find a long-running daytime show. Rounds 3 and 4 now. Coming up is the TV sum, which will require you to solve a TV clue to complete the sum. I will say we are using a 12-hour clock for that, you will see what I mean when we get there, but first it's TV titles. Identify the TV program from its title sequence. We have muted the theme tune. This time you have an extra clue with the names of the cast members appearing. Good luck. Round 5 is observation. A classic comedy clip is coming up. Watch very carefully.
Enter!
Dr. Johnson, Your Highness.
Ah, Dr. Johnson! Damn cold day!
Indeed it is, sir, but a very fine one. For I celebrated last night the encyclopedic implementation of my premeditated orchestration of demotic Anglo-Saxon.
Nope, didn't catch any of that.
Well, I simply observed, sir, that I'm felicitous, since during the course of the penultimate solar sojourn, I terminated my uninterrupted categorization of the vocabulary of our post-Norman tongue.
Well, I don't know what you're talking about, but it sounds damn saucy, you lucky thing. I know some fairly liberal-minded girls, but I've never penultimated any of them in their solar sojourn. For that matter, been given any Norman tongue.
I believe, sir, that the doctor is trying to tell you that he is happy because he has finished his book. It has apparently taken him 10 years.
Yes, well, I'm a slow reader myself.
Here it is, sir, the very cornerstone of English scholarship. This book, sir, contains every word in our beloved language.
Ooh. Every single one, sir?
Every single word, sir.
Oh, well, in that case, sir, I hope you will not object if I also offer the doctor my most enthusiastic contrafibularities.
What?
Contrafibularities, sir? It is a common word down our way.
Damn!
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I'm anaspeptic, phrasmotic, even compunctuous to have caused you such pericombobulation.
How long did Blackadder say the doctor had taken to finish his book? As always, we end with our quickfire channel hopping round. Three TV shows, but were they first shown in the UK on any BBC channel, any ITV channel, or any other channel? It's time for the answers. The two team captains on Have I Got News For You are Paul Merton and Ian Hislop. The daytime show in our anagram was this morning. Now for those titles, this time with the music. The answer was Wild at Heart, which ran for 7 series on ITV from 2006. Our TV Sum asked for the PM hour that the one show airs. That is 7 PM, and you had to multiply by 9, so the correct answer is 63. For round 5, how long had the doctor taken to finish his book? Over to Blackadder for the answer.
That the doctor is trying to tell you that he is happy because he has finished his book. It has apparently taken him 10 years.
Yes, well, I'm a slow reader myself.
The answer was 10 years. We finished with channel hopping. The Fast Show was first shown on BBC Two in 1994. The answer for Footballers' Wives was ITV. It ran for 5 series starting in 2002. You wanted to go back to BBC for your final answer. Like a lot of the classic children's shows, just 13 episodes of The Flumps were ever made. They all aired for the first time in 1977. And that completes today's TV teaser. Let us know how you scored in the comments. Remember, we are back with you every night at 7 PM in April, and all previous episodes are also available. Subscribe to the channel for free so you don't miss out. Did you know, it's not just quizzes on the channel as we also have an out and about section. Join PS himself for a tour of Hensby. It is very sad what is happening with all the coastal erosion there. Or see how the police operated the rolling roadblocks and see the cyclists sprint past to look back at when the tour of Britain hit Hunstan Tun. That's all for me, until the next TV teaser. Night, night.